is potentially an exciting front three that Milan start with here. The pace of Mbai Niang, the guile of Suso, and the finishing prowess of Luis Adriano. 17-year-old Gianluca Donnarumma, who became Milan's number one last season, starts in goal. Cesc Fabregas is back in the starting 11 for Chelsea following his sending off against Liverpool. Diego Costa and Bertrand Traore are partnered together at the heart of Chelsea's front four. No game time as of yet, though, for N'Golo Kante. Around about 60,000 inside this place, plenty of Chelsea fans here. And it will be Milan to get us underway in this International Champions Cup tie. Chelsea victors against Liverpool, but ripped apart really in the first 45 by Real Madrid. Eden Hazard's introduction gave the scoreline a little bit more respectability. Antonio Conte will be looking for better reign.
Oh, he certainly will, there's no doubt. Straight away you can see it's a 4-4-2 formation. Maybe at times Traore will just go a little bit deeper. And there'll be Diego Costa, that'll be the out-and-out attacker. Just seeing that Traore's getting quite close to Kuka, who's playing in a central role for AC Milan.
There's Bonaventura. Chelsea head home after this tonight, and they are looking to sign off in style here. It's the Milan team that Antonio Conte will know all about, having gone up against them in Serie A, and of course watched them on many, many occasions while scouting during his stint as national team manager. Calabria. Has delivered a dangerous looking ball, and Thibaut Courtois manages to make the save. He may have more work to do here. Like it was Abate, it was, who sneaked in at the far post, who made contact with that cross and almost caught Chelsea out.
Brilliant ball then, with an absolutely superb ball. He'd be asking the question of Azpilicueta, the fullback. That's his job, to get on the half turn. You can see the delivery coming in from the left hand side, and also, you know, who's coming in at the far post. He was caught out. Abate come in, he was at full stretch to try and get the header on target. You've got to say, good save by Courtois. Got his angles absolutely spot on.
There's Matic. Victor Moses on the outside, and Donnarumma with the save, but poaching was Traore. And Chelsea flex their muscle in Minneapolis.
Well, they've been caught out twice with the long throw, you know, AC Milan not picking up. Matic done brilliantly, because he could have took the shot on. He's seen that he had an overload over on that left-hand side with Victor Moses. He just played the ball beautifully in his path. Hit it with the inside of his right foot, trying to curl it towards the far post. Give the goalkeeper a bit of credit. Look at the space that he's in. No one picking him up. That's where Paulie's got to be picking up. Someone in the centre of midfield. There's the strike coming in. The keeper's made a decent save, but the reactions of Traore is absolutely fantastic. Look how quickly he's on to it. No, the defenders are there, they didn't react to it, he did. Just stabbed the header home into the empty net. Against the run of play, you would say that Chelsea have taken the lead. You've got to defend much better than that.
Adriano was claiming he was being pulled there as the corner goes short, and Chelsea steal possession back as Fabregas. Moses. Victor Moses almost found Willian.
Yeah, with a bit of an easier ball, not to Diego Costa though. Now he's trying to play it across the base of the 18-yard box to pick up Willian, and made an awful lot of ground up to support Victor Moses. Great run, lovely layoff there from Fabregas. It took Kuka out of the game, and now he's off and running Moses, but it was a simple ball on to Diego Costa. He went for the much harder one, which was Willian over on this right-hand side.
Matic. Rescue clearance. So that's Azpilicueta. Now Fabregas. There's Terry. Nice ball to Diego Costa. Costa to Moses. And the shot fired in and just wide of Gianluigi Donnarumma's left post as Azpilicueta set his sights.
Well, that's unusual for him to be that far up, Azpilicueta. Take the shot on, normally likes to pass the ball off. Doesn't want to take the responsibility, but this wasn't too far away. Certainly had the goalkeeper getting across his goal. Lutley had it covered.
Tura pulling the strings, looking for Abate, finding Abate, who will settle for the corner.
And who's picking him up? Victor Moses. You know, the two wide players for Chelsea, Moses on the left and Willian on the right, they're going to have to do a lot of chasing back. You know, it's like doggies, you've run up and down all the time. You know, when you win the ball, you're expected to make a 50-yard run forward to, you know, get at the opposition's fullback there. You have to defend as well. A lot of hard work for the midfield four, if you like.
Suso's corner, Paletta tried to reach it. Calabria was caught there by Willian.
This is a good area for AC Milan to take the free kick from. You see here, no need to go in for this, is he? Just checks him, doesn't he? Just sticks out his left leg, catches Calabria. There's a few lining up to take this.
They have a few decent technicians in the team. Suso's moved away, I think. They've got Bonaventura there, Luis Adriano, Niang.
Yeah, I'm just trying to see who's going to be the one to take charge of the situation. Maybe Bonaventura just having a word with his teammates. He's the most likely to take it. It's a big wall when you look at it. Matic in there and Diego Costa.
Bonaventura or Niang to strike this. It's Bonaventura! That is perfect!
Well, you said they had a few good technicians. Well, there's one of them, Bonaventura. Said it was a needless free kick to give away in a good area for AC Milan, but it's all about the quality of the free kick. He's got it up and over the wall, and you can't blame the goalkeeper. Well, he's protecting the other side, which he's duty-bound to do. He just tries to move across, tries to read it, but just can't get anywhere near it. Such is the quality. Just inside the near post. Brilliant free kick from Bonaventura. Up and over and got the dip in time to beat Courtois on the goal. See, overall, they thoroughly deserve that, AC Milan.
Well, he's no stranger to scoring goals from distance, Giacomo Bonaventura, and he's just stepped up with a beauty to level things in Minneapolis. It's a magic in the United States from Giacomo Bonaventura. That's Fabregas. Now Nemanja Matic. And Milan will feel they deserve that equaliser, particularly with the start they made to this game.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, for 40 minutes, there have been spells where they've dominated. I think Chelsea came back into it, obviously, when they scored the goal. And the confidence and momentum was with them.
Victor Moses. Donnarumma again, not convincing with his handling, though.
No, one of them times, Gary, you just take your eye off it. You know, it's so easy for Donnarumma. He's under no pressure at the near post. Really should be taking that quite comfortably. He spilled it. A bit fortunate. It wasn't much more pace when it came out of his hands there and heading towards the goal.
You can see how high Chelsea have stepped up there, so Donnarumma has to clear it long. Costa. This is Willian, the shining light in the Chelsea gloom last season. Niang running into trouble in the form of Ola Aina, and it's Aina, right back firing wide.
Yeah, good play from Ola Aina, but once again Niang. There's times when you've just got to clear the danger. He's, you know, he's done well initially, and then he's just strong there. Aina got away from Niang.
So Milan have ventured out for the second half. Chelsea will get his underway in his second 45. Chelsea looking to sign off in the States in style. They had the lead in this game thanks to a goal from Bertrand Traore before a Fantastic free kick from Giacomo Bonaventura. Level matters for Milan. Mate in hard on Victor Moses.
No, we've seen Montolivo on the sidelines look like he was about to go on to the field of play, but that doesn't look to be the case at the moment. Surprisingly, I don't think either side have made a change at the start of the second half.
But we know they will happen. Both managers will use their benches in the second 45. Eden Hazard amongst the Chelsea supporting cast. Chelsea still trying to land another striker. They will be knocking on Everton's door with an offer of £60 million for Romelu Lukaku and possibly include Loic Remy as part of a deal. In the next few days, Everton's valuation of Lukaku right now is £75 million. So we wait to see whether that deal gets done.
I think Chelsea said they're not going to go in with a higher offer either. You know, this is it.
And they sold for £28 million a couple of years ago. There's Andrea Poli.
Never really looked confident there, Poli, did he? He made options on the right-hand side. Apologetic to his teammates there. He was, what, 30 yards out, wasn't he? Expecting just to get his body weight over the top of the ball and maybe get the ball on target. Well wide.
Paletta. There's Donnarumma. Stands Milan aren't expected to trouble the top three this coming season. They finished seventh in the last campaign. Milan needs fixing, and Vincenzo Montella is hoping he has the answers. His minimum target this season is to finish in the Europa League places.
I'm not sure he's got the personnel to do that, and he hasn't certainly got the buying power, and that is the problem for AC Milan. A lot of talk about new owners coming in, but it's a bit late, you know, with the season starting, what, 2 weeks or so.
Calabria, Bonaventura, this is Niang, and Abate.
Well, he's had two chances, one at the start of the first half, where a header well saved by Courtois, and here's a right fullback in the central position. Niang done well just to set him up. A little deflection, I think it was off Matic into the path of Abate. Never looked confident, did he? Never really troubled Courtois.
Longest serving player at the club now, Ignacio Abate. That's Niang. Fancying the chance of some distance, Milan. Chelsea about to make another few changes, but Eden Hazard has played that perfectly into the path of Willian, and the keeper just about keeps it out. Donnarumma didn't really cover himself in glory to begin with. But he got the job done.
He flapped at a couple of things tonight, isn't he, Gary? The goalkeeper, a couple of shots he should have saved quite comfortably. That was a lot more difficult because there was a lot of power in that from Willian. Lovely pass from Hazard, wasn't it? Beautifully into his path.
This now is Cesc Fabregas. The door slammed shut.
Have a look at the options. Have a look at the number of AC Milan players in the box compared to Chelsea. Chelsea at two. There's about six from AC Milan. This is a very good strike, but the keeper still could have done a little better. There's a bit of movement on it.
John Terry, Matic, N'Golo Kante, Willian. And the ball from Willian is found. That's Aspilicueta, who appeals for handball, and he's got the penalty. Andrea Poli, the man who raised his arm, and Chelsea have a penalty kick.
Well, I said there was one earlier, and Batshuayi had a strike when Poli came out to block it. It looked like it came off his hand. On this occasion, the referee seen Aspilicueta with the ball across the face of the goal there. He's come out to close him down, and Taylor's not happy with it. So you hear from the replay, he's turned his back on. I don't think you can give a penalty for that when you've turned your back, your hands up. I don't think you've got any knowledge of actually trying to control it with your hands. So a bit of good fortune for Chelsea. Oscar about to take the penalty to try and put them in the lead.
Yeah, Oscar against the 17-year-old Gianluigi Donnarumma. He was a big, big goalkeeper. Oscar, clinical. And Chelsea in front again.
Well, the goalkeeper's guessed the right way, Donnarumma. Did everything possible to try and keep out, but such is the quality and the clinical finishing from Oscar. It's in the top corner. I mean, that's absolutely outstanding from his point of view. Never looked phased at all, did he? Supremely confident, just a couple of steps. But look at the pace and the power he got on it, the direction. Goalkeeper's at full stretch to keep it out, but you know, just couldn't get anywhere near it.
Chelsea haven't looked much better in the second half since they made the switch to a 4-3-3.
Yeah, I certainly agree with you there. You know, there's no doubt. I think Kante's settled in really well in front of the back four. Watch, when you watch him, he passes and moves. He's never standing still. He's always on the move. That's good advice for any youngsters.
Oscar! Chelsea signing off in estates in style.
Well, a double for Oscar, isn't it? Lovely through ball to pick him out. But what a good finish, wasn't it? Gave the goalkeeper Donnarumma no chance whatsoever. Just how quickly he took the shot on, he never got set the keeper to try and make the save. There's Cuadrado with the ball in, good movement in behind Vido. There's a strike coming, you see the goalkeeper can't even get down. Just pass him in an instant. Just watch the keeper here. Just can't move his body weight across to try and make the save, such was the power and direction of the strike from Oscar.
That should so this game up for Chelsea. Oscar, who stepped off the bench, has scored a clinical penalty, and that was ruthless too. He caught the eye of his manager, Antonio Conte, no question about that. Had an up and down time at Chelsea, hasn't he, Oscar?
Yeah, he has, there's no doubt. He's got quality, he's got ability, he's got a great attitude. Not just about scoring goals with this lad, he's got a great attitude getting around the pitch, making tackles. And it seems to be someone that, even when he's left out of the team, he never kicks up a fuss, he just gets on with it. When he's asked to come into the team and do a job, he does it to the best of his ability. I think the standout thing for me, Gary, watching this game, is quite simply 4-4-2 in the first half. Didn't particularly work for Chelsea. The manager obviously seen that, changed it for the second half, and they've looked a lot better. Everyone looked far happier. They all know the positions that they should be in.
Well, I guess for Antonio Conte, he wants to put his own stamp on this team. He knows things need fixing at Chelsea, but equally the players look to be more comfortable in that 4-3-3, a system they know very, very well.
Yeah, it's just, it seems that they've got just a lot bit more energy in this second half with the changes that they've made, you know, and I think that does come down to the system as well. You know, they're playing higher up the field, they've won the ball back in better areas, they weren't doing that in the first half. So there's been a real change in the emphasis from the Chelsea side in the second half. And maybe it's a bit of AC Milan being off the pace as well, not being as good as they were in that first half. But I think a lot of the credit has to go to Chelsea and the tactics that they've employed in the second half.
Oscar, who's stolen the show in the second half. Kante. Heading towards two additional minutes. Eden Hazard. There's Paletta. Harry Cahill. Now Batshuayi. Thrown out of the way by Paletta. It's one way of dealing with him.
He's looked okay, isn't he? I think he's actually dovetailed very well with Hazard, which you expect, playing in the Belgium national team together. They've got a good understanding, demanding more. That's what you want from your manager. 3-1 up in the last few minutes of the game, but still wants more out of his side.
Well, that's why he's losing his voice. Antonio Conte, who's been chewing on throat lozenges. When he started out as a manager, he used to bark instructions out with a megaphone. He may need that again soon if he continues in this manner. There's Honda. Cahill just took a whack. This is Kante being closed down by Zanellato. Kante standing his ground really well.
Brilliant, that's brilliant play there from Kante. How strong was he in possession of the ball there?
Cuadrado with the step-overs and left floored. That's Matri. Eden Hazard. Zanellato steals the ball away from him. Yeah, Milan since he was an eight-year-old, Nicolo Zanellato. Milan fan. It's Chelsea's night in Minneapolis. The last hurrah in the United States of America for this summer. Oscar scoring twice in the second half. What a clinical penalty. The other really ruthless finish after being sent on at half-time by Antonio Conte. Chelsea beating Milan by 3-1. Bertrand Traore put them in front with a poacher's finish in the first half and a wonderful free kick. From Giacomo Bonaventura, level matters up. Chelsea changed to 4-3-3 in the second half. They look more comfortable in their old system. And Oscar scored twice to win this game, ultimately for Chelsea at the wonderful US Bank Stadium.